Amen. Thank you, Minister. Amen. God bless the entire church family, the family of this wonderful ministry, Minister Uburn. We all celebrate the gift of Christ, Christ coming to earth. And we have such access and such privilege to know the Lord Jesus Christ. It's amazing, and it's quite fascinating. I'm one of those who are eternally grateful that I've come to know the Lord. And this morning, as we look at a devotion, and we're coming at the end of the year, the honest truth is I'd love to give you something that is very Christmassy, but the truth is I can't. I really can't. And because the Lord will not let me get away from this, because I've been absent for a while, and I'll tell you why. Indeed, not that I was just busy with family, but I went through a series of testing, and I asked myself, if I was on, would it be my emotion speaking, or would it be the Lord that would be speaking or using me to speak? And I had to gauge myself and ask myself that question: who would be speaking? Is it me, or would it be the Lord? And I'll just tell you my testings that I've been through, and I share what I want to do this morning is share my testimony with what I have been going through. And when I was with the devotions and I was regular, my father had a surgery, and he was in the hospital locally, and then he had to be flown to Florida for treatment, and then he did a neck surgery. And I want to say this to say, I thank God that my father is doing much, much better. My father he's over 70 years old, and he had 4 major surgery. And it's been a trying time for my family. It's been a trying time for my entire family and for my faith, because I sincerely believe that my father was demonically attacked. I sincerely believe that my father was attacked, and I knew it was from the pits of hell that Satan has been working, set to work, I would say, against me and my family. So I didn't want to say much, because I didn't know if my emotions would have been speaking, or it would have been God wanting me to speak about what we have been going through. And when I thought about what I would say this morning, what the Lord said to me was, if your life, if the Bible was dependent upon your life, me and your life, could it be written today? And what I mean by that, if God had to write the Bible based on all life today, could the scribes depend upon us to share what we have been going through so God will get the glory? Because back then, we read a Bible of people's lives and people's testimony. That's what we have as scriptures today. The Syrophoenician woman who had an issue with blood. The woman who had the issue with blood, the Syrophoenician woman who Jesus said, don't give the children bread to dogs. The man's son who was demon possessed, and Christ said, this kind goeth not out by fasting and prayer. Naaman, who had to dip in the river. We have testimonies upon testimonies of people who we can look back to and read and be encouraged and say, God is a healer. God is a deliverer. God will fight for you. God will do for you. We have countless that we can refer back to. And I heard the Lord asking, if the Bible was to be written now, could I depend on you all who are now here for the Bible to be written? And I thought about it, because we are now living in an age where we are politically correct. We think about, if God did something for me, I don't want anybody else to hear, because they might take my business and they might go and spell over things how it shouldn't be. And I when I heard that, I said, God, I am one of those people, because you have done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. And you have done so much for me. And I don't think I have been as vocal, not because I am ashamed, but because I think I am more thinking politically correct. What's this church doctrine? We get so churchy, we get so politically correct, we don't want to spell over things because it might get here. We're on Facebook, we're on radio. I come here this morning, minister, and to the listening audience, to remind somebody, when God has done for us, it is not to be kept a secret. God didn't do it. God did it so that we could talk and others could hear that God is still a healer. God is still a deliverer. God is still the awesome Jehovah that he was in Genesis to Revelation. He is still God. He hasn't changed. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is God. And Jesus is still the same, just as his lovely name. He is still the same. So before I could say anything, I want to testify of the gift God gave to my family. My father had 4 major surgeries. His intestine was looped against itself, and he could not have natural movement of the bowels. They went in, they did surgery. They had to go back in a second time, do another surgery. They went back in a third time and did surgery. And I believe all that was done to take my father out. But prayers were sent up and prayers were asked, and we petitioned heaven. And my father is a miracle today. He's home. He's walking around. Things my father couldn't do, he's now doing. And I thank God. My mother was in the hospital while my father was doing his 4th surgery to do the reconnections and recorrections from the previous surgery. My mother was there. Behold, my brother Carl, and say, "Mommy has to do surgery in the said hospital." I said, "Wow." My mother had a heart attack, the doctor said. My mother had a stroke and a mild stroke and a mild heart attack. My mother had to go under the knife in Cleveland Clinic. And my mother said she never felt pain before, nothing. She had no signs. And she went back a couple weeks back to the doctor. And the doctor said to her, "I think they overreacted. You have no sign of anyone who previously had a heart attack or a stroke. You have no signs. Your health looked perfect." I said, "Mommy, I know it's the enemy who had attacked my father and then he attacked my mother." To compound the issue, I was home sleeping. Somebody brought 4 plants to me. I took it as nothing. My wife was skeptical. And then when I took it, I heard the Lord saying, "Get rid of those plants. Get rid of them." I said, "No, man, they're just plants. They're nice trees. They're plants." Soon after, a couple days later, I was sleeping. I kid you not. I lie not. I don't lie, and I'm not making story up to sound super spiritual. I'm not trying to impress anybody. This is why I was absent, because I could not think for me, for the life of me, if I should have said anything to the audience. But I was home sleeping one of the nights, and behold, while I was sleeping, I felt a demon spirit came and pushed its hands in my side from the right side to my left, and it pushed on one of my organs. And from then on, when I got up, my body starts shutting down. Basically, the nights after that happened, I couldn't sleep. Pain, excruciating pain. I couldn't breathe. I was on my back. I couldn't breathe. I go on my side. I couldn't breathe. I lay on my stomach. I couldn't breathe while I was sleeping. The pain that I was going through was excruciating. When I went to the doctor up here, I couldn't even sit on the table. The pain I was going through. I laid on the table, and the doctor sent me to Tortola to get a test to check what's going on. When I was about to leave, after I did the test, the nurse, the doctor said, "Where are you going?" I said, "Back to Virgin Water." She said, "No, you can't." My phone rang. The doctor said, "You can't go back to Virgin Water. This is an emergency." "What?" She said, "What you have is a bulla of the lungs. Your lung, going to the emergency room." I sent out prayer requests to my prayer circle. We prayed. One of the prayer warriors said to me, a lady in Tatula, she said to me, "You will not have surgery." At then, I couldn't believe it. I said, as far as I know, I said, "Man, my father had surgery. My mother had surgery. It looked like this devil is out to do something drastic to my family." I walked to the emergency room, and kid you not, when I went there, they run some more tests before they did the surgical procedure. And they came back at about 8 o'clock. I was down there from 12:40. At 8 o'clock in the night, the lady that was doing it, she said, we can't see nothing. We can't find nothing. But what had happened, the Lord had told me before I had reached the doctor. And I'm saying this to say, these are things in the church we don't want to talk about because we feel the news may get back to the people and who did it. I am here, standing here. I, Gregory Alvino George the First, that live in Virgin Gorda, will tell you. And if it get back, I don't mind. I will testify of God. Witches were sent against my family. A witch was sent against me. It came and it touched my body. And I nearly died. When I went back to the doctor in Virgin Gorda, she said to me, this is the second time I've ever seen a case where someone has a bull of the lungs. She said, the first time I seen this was a doctor friend. And they were in the emergency room for months. When I heard that, I said, wow, the enemy meant to set me in an emergency room for months. I would have my family, my everything, my world would have been turned upside down. I would have more than likely lost my job. I would have more than likely lose the church. My wife would have been frustrated with three young kids and her life to take care of her husband. It would have been chaotic. My father would have been sick. My mother would have been taking care of my father. My family would have been helping take care of my mother. It would have been chaotic. I'm saying all of that to say, in Revelation 12 and 11, it said we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of his testimony of our testimony, the word of our testimony. Church, we are too quiet for the goodness that's been done to us. We have been too quiet for too long, and we have kept our mouth shut while others suffer, thinking God don't answer prayer. I am here to remind you that Jesus Christ, we bow our knees to. The God we look up in heaven is much greater than any devil out of hell, any demon that walk in day or noonday, any witchcraft worker from Africa, Nigeria, Europe, from wherever part of the world. The God that we serve is bigger than any devil. And I sit here this morning to remind somebody, Jesus Christ is greater than Satan. There's no comparison. The devil is defeated. Every attack against the church, it will not prosper. When you remain in God and God be your strength, God is looking for people. One of my favorite scriptures is 2 Chronicles 16 and 9. The eyes of the Lord run to and fro the whole earth, looking for those whose hearts are perfect towards him. So he may, so that he may show himself strong on their behalf. He was speaking about Asa, who had a disease in his foot. He said, but Asa sought not the Lord. He didn't seek the Lord, and he died of his disease. God is saying, when you find yourself in sickness, when you find yourself in problem, when you find yourself in situation on your job, in your marriage, when you find yourself where people trying to work necromancy, witchcraft, black magic, white magic, purple magic against you, God said, seek he first. Don't go to nobody. Don't run to no other witchcraft doctor. Don't go putting your faith in man and in people. Put your faith in the blood of Jesus Christ. Call upon the elders. Call upon the power, those who know the power of prayer, who are afraid of no demon. Because in church, if I dare say, there's many church believers who are afraid of demons. If they hear about demonic warfare and casting out demons, they're scared. They run. They call it psychological problem. They say you're having different issues. Jesus walked this earth, and Jesus' ministry was mainly casting demons out. He cast demons out. He cast them out. He took them out of people. He cast them. Sicknesses were originally demonic origins. The devil is still a liar. He makes us feel as though there's medical problem. The devil can mimic a genuine medical situation and make it look like it's a medical when it's a demonic witchcraft attack. But I'm here standing. I'm here speaking to you this morning I'm here to give you an encouragement. I'm here to let you know. A demon came into my room, pushed his hands in my side, and meant to kill me, meant to set me down in people hospital or some foreign hospital and destroy my life, my family, and my ministry. But the blood still works. The blood of Jesus works, minister. The blood works, church. The blood of Jesus still works. And so I'm here to say to you, I'm here to say to us, as we close this year, God has given us the gift of his only begotten son, Jesus. That's the gift of salvation. But there's many more presents, like miracles, like deliverance. There are many more miracles, like favor, blessings, and breakthrough that God has given unto us. And some of us has been extremely ungrateful. We haven't said, thank you, Jesus. We haven't made it public because we think people going to now take it, turn it and twist it. And all of a sudden, our name going to be out there. Well, I give you permission. Use my name. Tell them. They set witches against Pastor Greg and Virtue Gorda. And the man is still here. The man is still standing. The man is a warrior for Jesus Christ. I told God, God, before Greg bowed to any witch or any necromancy, I will come home to meet you in heaven. That's for sure. But be it known, may be inscribed at earth and in heaven, Jesus, that Greg will never give up to any witchcraft, any demon, any susu, any demonic warfare. They could send them. But Greg will not bow. Greg will not beg Satan for mercy. Greg will not compromise his faith. Me ain't going looking for no witch man cross, no other island to give me no answer for my problem. I am looking for the present help. Yatelebosia, who said in times of trouble, he will be that present help. I am looking to the cross. I'm looking for Jesus Christ. I'm looking for my maker. I'm looking for my savior. I'm looking for my strong tower. I'm looking to my deliverer. I'm looking to my horn on the altar. I'm looking to the bridge over troubled waters. I'm looking to Jesus Christ. May this year end with you being bold for God. And you will speak up with your faith that God is still who God say he is. That God is still God, that he sits on the throne and he waits for men affairs to be brought towards heaven, that God will show himself strong on your behalf. So I challenge you. This Christmas, I want to give God the thanks and the praise for what God has done. I thank Jesus Christ for all his many miracles, his many blessings. My mom has another test to do, and she didn't give me permission to say this. My mom went and did a test the other day, and the test looked sketchy, and they said to her that they don't know, she need to come and do another one. I went to my mom last night. I prayed over her. I cried. I prayed. I sang songs, and I prayed the word of God. We believe God by his stripe that we are healed. I believe God. I took out my shofar. I blew my shofar, and I'm believing God for a total different report. Because my mother time isn't yet come. Satan would keep on walking. The devil and his enemies and the wicked people on this earth, they could keep on walking. But we're going to keep on believing the God we serve. I told God, God, I am asking you for mercy for my parents and for my life. But I am not easing up in 2020. I am giving God the glory and praise because he deserves every inch, every bit. May we live with our mouth as a pen of the ready writer to give God praise. Etched it in heaven, etched it in the world, that Christ is a deliverer. He is a deliverer. Let me just say this. And still I'm talking fast. Let me just say this. This is how bad people in the Obia world brag about their accomplishment. I got her. I got he. Watch at them. Look at their child. Look at their business. Look at their marriage. They brag about it, you know. A young man met me. And this is how I know that they've been. But that's not how I know. This is how I know they talk about their successes. A young man met me and he said to me, he watched me, he said, they say they can't handle you. They say they're trying to handle you, but they can't get you handled. And I looked at him and I knew what that meant. What he was saying to me, they send the witchcraft after me. They send so much of it, but they couldn't get me handled. I walked, I saw a snake in my road. When I took the snake up, the voices of the spirit start speaking. I there was a dead cat in my yard. When I take it up, I nearly faint. I had to call for some pastors and prayer warriors. They came up and deacon, and we prayed, we burn it. Don't follow what I do. Let me just say this. Don't follow what I do. Make sure God tells you what to do when you're dealing with witchcraft. I can talk more about that another time. But I came home. There was a snake in my house. There was a snake on my deck. There was a snake in my yard. And all of them meant to send. There was a signs of what it was. The Lord had told me the third snake, that it was coming. And when I reached home, I heard my children screaming, "Daddy, a snake in the house." I came up and I said, "No, I was expecting you." I was daily expecting you. But I said, "Not today, snake, not today. I'm so sorry." I wouldn't tell you how that ends, but I can tell you that much. We don't run from devils. I'm just saying this, we don't run. And the young man said to me, "They're trying to handle you, but they say they can't get to do." I responded to him and said, "Yes, because if they think they see me as ordinary, I am no little boy in Jesus Christ. I am a true vetted soldier in the blood of Jesus Christ. A warrior. I am a warrior. I am a warrior for Jesus Christ." I'm saying this, church, because I want to encourage somebody's faith, because I feel the church is weak when it comes to warfare. We are scared when it comes to demon. But you must not run, for God has not given you a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. Keep your head on. Think straight. Look up for your help coming from the Lord. Look up for your Redeemer is still on the throne. Look up. Be encouraged that God is still God. He's a loving God. He's an awesome God. He's a grateful Savior. Time is going. I can say so much more. But, oh, Lord Jesus, I wish you, church, and our fellowship, I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you all above God that you prosper and be in good health. I wish you 2020 will be a year of boldness, that we will not spare, we will not let go, we will call no truce, but you will not spare, you will not compromise, you will not be simple, but you will be passionate, you will be bold, you will be outspoken for God in 2020. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. May Christ always be the reason for this season. And while we have life and remain upon this earth, may we give God the glory. May we talk about our story. May we let others know that Jesus indeed answer prayer. He does. He will. He has. He will continue to answer prayer. May you be encouraged, church. God bless you. I love you with the love of the Lord. I hope my testimony made sense, but I just want to say this. Revelations 12 and 11. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. Do not fail to testify what God has done for you. Do not fail to give God thanks. Do not fail to give him praise. Open your mouth. Let it be known. Share it in the church. Share it on Facebook. Let them know. I'm going to put up my post, by the way. I've never said anything. This is the first time I'm saying something on a public medium like this about it. I'm going to put it up. I'm going to write it clearly. I've been attacked by a witch. They came and they failed. And to Jesus Christ be the glory. Satan defeated. Hallelujah. Satan defeated. Hallelujah. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God. God bless you. God bless you.